यस अदर्स यस थैंक यू हरे कृष्णा. सो आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर आवर थर्ड सेशन ऑफ दिस थीम ऑफ टेस्ट ऑफ अ ट्रू गुरु एंड टेस्ट ऑफ अ जेन्युइन डिसाइपल राइट और अ टेस्ट ऑफ अ सिंसियर डिसाइपल. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी फ्यू थिंग्स विच वी लेफ्ट आउट इन द प्रीवियस सेशंस एंड वी विल take ahead the discussion about the mentor system or counselor system which we have in our Krishna consciousness and we will try to learn about it. So before we start the discussion, we will chant short prayer. So all of you kindly repeat after me. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमः ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामीनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुं दीनतारिणं. हरे कृष्णा. वन मिनट. सो लास्ट टू सेशंस ऑन लास्ट वीकेंड वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट test of a genuine guru and test of a sincere disciple. So I would just like to quickly recap and then we'll go ahead with the discussion. Where is the file? Just one minute. Yes. I hope the screen is visible. Is the screen visible for everyone? Okay, thank you. So we discussed these topic, these points or these themes in our discussion. What is the test of a genuine guru? These are just bullet points I have listed, which we discussed in detail in last weekend. A genuine guru is one who speaks about God. I just want to know, there are some devotees also from Kolhapur. So I hope everyone is okay with English. There is no one who doesn't understand English, right? I think everyone understands English. Yeah. Okay. In case you have a problem, you can type in chat. I can use Hindi also in between if required. So a genuine guru is one who speaks about God and not about how to enjoy the material world in a better way. And guru doesn't teach how to live peacefully and very happily in this world. Of course, you know, when we become devotees, guru teaches us naturally this living in this world becomes quite easier than a person who is just looking for material happiness. But a guru teaches how to love God. The guru must have sense control. We discussed about this also in detail. Guru should be decorated with all saintly qualities. We quoted from Srimad Bhagavad Gita, right? amanitvam, adambitvam, ahimsa, kshantirarjavam. So many qualities are mentioned in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Guru is not interested in increasing cheap followers in big number by compromising the teachings. We saw examples of Srila Prabhupada when he went to US, never compromised. Although, you know, he could have got many, many followers by compromising. The Guru doesn't do that. Right? He's not interested in increasing cheap followership. He does not bluff, but speaks from scriptures. Right? That Guru Sadhu Shastra, that triangle I told, you have to always cross-check whether the person who is speaking is bluffing or he is speaking genuine, bona fide knowledge from the scriptures. He collects respect and worship of all living beings and offers it to God. He doesn't keep it with himself. Right? The Guru offers whatever respect is given to him, he offers it to his Guru and the Supreme Lord. A Guru canvasses everyone on behalf of God to become a devotee of God. He is a representative of Krishna. Because Krishna is teaching in Bhagavad Gita, man mana bhava mad bhakto madhyaji mam namaskuru. He is a lover of God and propagates love of God. Never claims himself to be God, right? But always delights in acting as servant of God. So, Prabhupada was asked, are you God? He was asked, are you a guru of this whole world? What to speak of God? Prabhupada said, I am, you know, just trying to be a servant, right? So, a guru never claims himself to be God, because the living entity cannot be God. You know, we are servants of God. If qualified with spiritual knowledge, it is immaterial what caste or nationality guru belongs to, right? So, a genuine guru should not be judged on his material aspects of his birth, his color, his caste, creed, his religion and all other things. He is part of one of the four authorized sampradayas. That also we discussed in detail. Brahma sampradaya, Shri sampradaya, Rudra sampradaya and Kumara sampradaya. And check and balance as we discussed. Guru, Sadhu, Shastra. That is very important. Then we also discussed about test of a sincere disciple. So a disciple should approach Guru with these three characteristics. With these three, you know, as his mood in his heart. It is said in that verse that tadvidhi pranipatena pariprashnena sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninas tattvadarshinaha. So Krishna explains that tadvidhi, understand the process of approaching a spiritual master. Pranipatena, humble surrender, right? And pariprashnena, inquisitive about long-term goal of life. A disciple should be inquisitive about spiritual aspects of life. He should not be inquisitive of the temporary aspects of this material world. And then pariprashnena and sevaya, by submissive service to the spiritual master. By this, if we approach the genuine spiritual master, genuine guru, upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninas tattva darshinaha, they will give that jnana, that knowledge, right? That will get transferred into our hearts because they have seen the truth as it is. And a sincere disciple is looking only for devotion to the Supreme Lord. He's not looking for temporary things of this world. Then he is a sincere spiritual seeker or disciple. Unflinching faith in the order of Guru. We saw the example of Srila Prabhupada, that how he was given the instruction of preaching this message of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavat in the English language throughout the whole world, and Srila Prabhupada took it as his life and soul and did it, right? He went to United States and preached and made so many devotees all around the world, sacrificing his own personal things at a very advanced age because he had faith on the order of his spiritual master that yes, my spiritual master has given me this instruction, I have to give my life and soul for his pleasure. So, that is unflinching faith in the order of Guru. That is a test of a sincere disciple. So, now we will discuss a few more things which we had left out. We couldn't continue and we couldn't complete last time. And then we'll move to the very important discussion which we are having today about the counselor system or mentor system in our Krishna consciousness. So, okay, we understood that there these are the characteristics of a genuine guru and a sincere disciple. Then what are the different types of gurus? Right? I have just listed, made this document for so that we read, it becomes easy for all of you also to understand. And I have compiled some things from here, there, and made this for all of you to understand in a better way. So what are different types of gurus? So it is explained in the scriptures, there are three types of gurus mainly. Or you can say four. We have not, I have not listed here the fourth one. So the first one is Vartma Pradarshak Guru or Patha Pradarshak Guru. Vartma means path. Patha also means path. So he is a guru who shows the right path of spiritual life or Krishna consciousness to us. So there can be many Vartma Pradarshak or Patha Pradarshak gurus. Even if someone says you or would have said to you that, you know, you go to that Hare Krishna temple, they are very genuine devotees of Krishna. You will find a very nice atmosphere there. You will find very nice philosophy there. So he is your Vartma Pradarshak Guru. Anyone can be a Patha Pradarshak Guru. Anyone who guided you on the right path. Like for Dhruva Maharaj. So when he was insulted by his father and his stepmother, his mother told him, you know, go to the forest. Or mother told him, you take shelter of Narayan or Vishnu. He will give you love of thousands of mothers. Right? And you don't have to hanker for anything of this material world. And then Dhruva, a five-year-old child, asked, where will I get Vishnu? And the mother said, great sages and saints find him in forest by doing meditation, because that was a different age. Of course, he chanted also holy names, but he meditated on the Supreme Lord's form. And then his mother showed him the way. And then he met Narad Muni on the path, right? So his mother became his Patha Pradarshak Guru. You know, she showed the right path to him. So that way, there can be many Patha Pradarshak Gurus or Vartma Pradarshak Gurus which show us the right path. They are also Gurus, right? Because they gave us the right direction. Then there is Shiksha Guru. What the Shiksha Guru does? He gives instructions of Krishna consciousness and he connects us to Parampara. He is also coming in Parampara. But that connection is not a formal connection, right? There is no commitment. There is no formal connection, relationship established. But there is a relationship in heart, in Shiksha Guru. So there can be many Shiksha Gurus from whom we get inspiration to follow the path of Krishna consciousness, take to the process of devotional service, follow the rules and regulations, read scriptures, and chant the holy names of Lord. So from those whom we get inspired and we get more knowledge of Krishna consciousness, they are Shiksha Gurus, right? They are instructive spiritual masters. And then there is Diksha Guru, who is only one. You cannot have many Diksha Gurus. A Diksha Guru is the one who initiates the disciple in the Guru Shishya Parampara. There is a formal connection and there is a commitment, right, in that relationship. So Diksha Guru also gives instructions. He initiates and officiates the connection to Parampara when the initiation happens. He gives a spiritual name to the candidate, that is a spiritual identity. He gives mantra. He accepts disciples' vows at the time of initiation. And he removes the disciples' sinful reactions at the time of initiation. So that's what Diksha Guru does. And for many of the devotees in our Hare Krishna movement, Diksha Guru is a prominent Shiksha Guru also. It's not that a Diksha Guru doesn't give Shiksha. Yes, he also gives instructions. But he does much more than giving only instructions, right? So a Diksha Guru is also a Shiksha Guru for most of the devotees in our Hare Krishna movement. So these are different types of gurus. And there is also one very important guru which I somehow missed here while listing. That is called as Chaitya Guru, which is the Paramatma in the heart of every living being. That Paramatma also gives guidance at times. So the Paramatma is sitting in the heart. You know, Krishna explains in Bhagavad Gita that भर्ता भोक्ता, और हाउ डज इट स्टार्ट, परमात्मेति चाप्युक्तो लोकेस्मिन् पुरुषः परः. एंड ही आल्सो एक्सप्लेन्स अनदर फंक्शन व्हाट परमात्मा डज, उपद्रष्टा अनुमंता च भर्ता भोक्ता महेश्वरः. राइट, सो ही इज उपद्रष्टा, ही वॉचेस, अनुमंता इज सैंक्शनर, भर्ता भोक्ता महेश्वरः, एंड ही इज सिटिंग इन द हार्ट ऑफ एवरी लिविंग एंटिटी इन दिस वर्ल्ड. सर्वस्य चाहम हृदि सन्निविष्टो, राइट, मत्तः स्मृतिर ज्ञानम अपोहनम च, फ्रॉम मी कम्स रिमेम्बरेंस, फॉरगेटफुलनेस एंड नॉलेज. दैट्स व्हाट कृष्णा सेज. सो कृष्णा इज देयर इन द हार्ट एज चैत्य गुरु, एज परमात्मा. सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ गुरुज विच वी हैव, एंड वी हैव अ स्पेशल पोजिशन ऑफ शीला प्रभुपाद इन अवर हरे कृष्ण मूवमेंट इन इस्कॉन. Srila Prabhupada is a very special empowered representative of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who spread the mission and the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam all over the world. Srila Prabhupada is also founder Acharya for the whole of ISKCON, International Society for Krishna Consciousness, and he is preeminent Shiksha Guru for all ISKCON devotees. What does it mean? All other Shiksha Gurus and Diksha Gurus, they will give the teachings in line with what Srila Prabhupada taught us when he was personally present, through his lectures, through his letters, through his conversations, through his books which he wrote. So whatever Srila Prabhupada has taught, in the same line, all other Shiksha Gurus and Diksha Gurus in ISKCON will give us teachings. You know, they will not teach something which is not in line with what Srila Prabhupada taught. So that is the special position of Srila Prabhupada. He is the founder and also Acharya. When we say Acharya, you know, one who teaches by his own example, Acharan, right? From that word comes Acharya. So that's why he is preeminent Shiksha Guru. He taught us by his classes, his lectures, you know, his conversations, his books, and also by his own personal example, which he exhibited, right? When he was present on this planet. Okay, so now questions may come, why we have to take Diksha, what is the need, and what is the procedure of taking Diksha, what are the qualifications required, who all are the Diksha Gurus in ISKCON, who all are the Shiksha Gurus in ISKCON, right? Details of all these things are there. We are not going to discuss all those details here, because there is a special course for this, which is called as ISKCON Disciples Course, IDC, which is a 4-day long course. And those who are serious in spiritual life and want to pursue, right, are interested in becoming serious on the path of spiritual realization, they all can take, right, this IDC course, ISKCON Disciples course. So the qualification for attending this course, you know, that will be conveyed to you. Those who are interested, you can tell. In future, we will be announcing about this course. So, but we will not go into detail of this ISKCON Disciples course. I'll just show you a brief summary, what is there in this course. You know, it's just a snapshot. There are 4 units. There is welcome introduction, Guru Tattva, Parampara, Srila Prabhupada, ISKCON Founder Acharya, ISKCON Gurus, Guru Padashray, Selection of Guru, Initiation Vows, Guru Puja, Guru Seva, Guru Apu Vani Seva, right? Like that, we have many topics. Then we have presenting one's guru, relationship within ISKCON. Like that, there are many detailed topics and detailed discussion that is not required as of now. So with this discussion, are there any questions about what we discussed last time on last weekend and what we discussed today? If there are questions, I will take for 2-3 minutes and then we'll go to ahead for today's important discussion. Are there any questions about what we discussed? If you have, you can unmute and ask, or you can type in the chat box. Who is the guru who gives sannyas? Okay. Actually, sannyas is another diksha that is called sannyas diksha. So that can be given by any sannyasi. Like Srila Prabhupada accepted after his grihastha ashram. Srila Prabhupada accepted sannyas in 1959, but that time his spiritual master was not there. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, Prabhupada's spiritual master, left in 1936. So in 1959, Srila Prabhupada accepted sannyas from his senior god brother, who was also a sannyasi. So any sannyasi in a Vaishnava order can award sannyas, can give sannyas initiation, right? So that is not your spiritual master. He is your sannyas guru, right? He is not your diksha guru. He is sannyas guru. So that can be given by any sannyasi. Any other question on what we discussed? If not, then we'll go ahead. Oji, what is meaning of HHHG in ISKCON? Okay. So HH is a short form of His Holiness. His Holiness, or you can say in Hindi, Paramapujya. Paramapujya means he is worshipable. So that is used for the sannyasis, those who are in sannyas order. And HG means His Grace or Her Grace. That is also called as Shriman or Shrimati. So somehow Shrimati sometimes, you know, in Hindu culture is used for a widow, but some places in India, but that's not necessarily, somehow that culture has spread. But all the initiated disciples, initiated devotees, they are given this prefix before their names as a respect from a person, right? His grace, that is Krishna's grace, you know? So he, or her grace, when we say, it is like Srimati Radharani's grace. So they are given this respect, right? So that is the way of calling. This is used only for initiated devotees. If he is a Prabhuji, a male, we use His Grace. Or if she is a lady, then we use Mataji. For Mataji, we use Her Grace, right? So these are the prefix used as a respect. How Diksha works? Oh, that's a detailed discussion. That will be done in IDC. If I start answering, it will take half an hour. It's a very detailed and technical and many scriptural references, and it will consume a lot of time. If you are interested, you can join IDC at right time. We are going to hold one IDC batch now. Mostly, I will be teaching. There are already some of our senior devotees who have been practicing from many years, but they have somehow not done this course. So those who are interested, we will declare the qualifications and who all can join. So that time, those questions will get answered. I hope no other questions and we go ahead. Is it all right? Okay. So now the next topic is spiritual counseling or mentoring system and its importance. Can you please repeat it? What shall I repeat? What to repeat? About joining IDC course, that ISKCON Disciples course, we will let you know. When that batch is going to start, we will let you know what are the qualifications, who all can join. And then you can join if you are fitting into that. We have some number of rounds. I'm not sure whether it's 8 rounds or something. If you are chanting, I think 4 or 8 rounds every day, you can join this. I'll just check because it's a long time. You know, I have not in touch with this course. So I will let you know soon. But there is detailed description in that course. Okay. So next topic is, that is a very important discussion, spiritual counseling, mentoring system and its importance. Whether you call it as counseling or mentoring, it's same. Some places they use mentor because counselor word has some connotations in today's world. It is seen as some psychological or, you know, problem or some marital issue, you know, all those things. But here it is about spiritual counseling. So in Pune, we generally use this word counselor only. But some other places in ISKCON, you will find this word as mentoring. So don't worry, both the same. Okay, so now in this topic, we'll be discussing what is it? What is this counseling system, counselor system, counselor and counselee? What is the need of it? What is the purpose of counselor system? How does it work? And how is a counselor nominated? What are the responsibilities of counselors? What are the trainings imparted to counselees? And what are the counselor meeting formats when they meet, counselor and counselee? These are rough things. And if you have any questions, you keep in mind and we'll all discuss at the end. Can we have one of you who has good internet connection and good microphone who can read? I will be showing some lines. You can read one by one and in between I will discuss whenever required. Who would like to volunteer? You can unmute yourself. You should not have a bad connection. Others will, you know, have a problem. Anyone who can read clearly and slowly, not too fast, and has a good mic and internet connection. Yes, who would like to volunteer? Quickly, anyone? We can change also. Every one topic will change if you want. If you are feeling it too difficult. So you don't have rights for unmute, I think. Okay, Chaitanya. You can unmute yourself, just check.
Yes, Roj.
Yes, okay. So we'll go one by one into these topics. The first is, what is the need of this spiritual counseling? So sometimes people get this question. This bhakti is of heart. Why there are so many systems and so many, hierarchies, and why I should be in, you know, these systems things. Bhakti is done by heart and all those things. Sometimes questions come. So we will see what is the need of this spiritual counseling and mentoring system. Yes. First topic is, what is the need? Yes, you can read one point. Yes, go ahead.
We need, number one, what is the need? We need personal guidance and attention in all walks of life, education, health, profession, etc. Same way, we all need personal connection and guidance with a senior spiritual party
practitioner.
Practitioner to advance on the spiritual. Which slide?
It's not visible.
Thoda upar lijiye.
Okay. Is it visible?
Yes.
Yeah. So just as we need guidance in all walks of our life, education, health, profession, everywhere, you know, we don't work without guidance. So in spiritual life also, we all need personal guidance. Yes, there are books, there are lectures, there are so many things available, but we need a personal one-to-one touch, because we are all individuals. We all face individual challenges. We all have our individual circumstances and situations in our life, which we need to tackle in order to, because spiritual life in this material world means there will be so many difficulties, there will be so many problems and challenges. And that too in today's day and age and world, wherein the whole society is going in completely opposite direction, we surely need a personalized guidance for advancing in our spiritual life. And as we saw, there are Diksha Gurus, and we may get Diksha, we may get connected to a spiritual master also, but we may not have a very personal contact, because it's practically very difficult. That's we'll see ahead, right? So that is very important to have a personal one-to-one connection with a senior spiritual practitioner who can help us. It's not that our spiritual advancement will be bound because of connection with that person. No, there is spiritual Diksha Guru. There are so many senior Diksha Gurus. There is Krishna there, and they are all helping us to come ahead in our spiritual life. But we don't have access to Krishna directly. If you go in front of deity and ask a question, we are not qualified that Krishna will come and answer. And because of practicalities, we cannot be directly, everyone cannot be in direct personal day-to-day touch with a Diksha Guru. That is also very difficult. So that's why we need a person. Yes, read ahead. Second point. Quick. Is there or left? Someone just, else can read quickly.
Just as there are difficulties in every walk of our life, there are difficulties on the path of spiritual life as well. We all are individuals and thus need a personalization
version of solution to all those problems. That's what we discuss, right? We all seek for loving and caring relationships in this world. So this is also a very important point. Everyone is looking for love and care. And that's what Rupa Goswami Pad writes in Nectar of Instruction or Upadeshamrut. A very beautiful verse. He says, it is visible, last line of these two lines of the verse are visible.
Yes, sir.
Visible, na? Yeah. So I understand. I'll accordingly move it up. So he says, Dadati pratigrinhati guhyam akhyati pruchati bhunte bhojayate chaiva shadvidham priti lakshanam. He says these are priti lakshanas. These are the symptoms of love. Six symptoms of love. What are the six symptoms of love in a relationship and especially in a spiritual relationship? Dadati pratigrinhati. He gives gifts and accepts gifts. Right? By this, the relationship, the love in the relationship will increase. Guhyam akhyati pruchati. He talks in confidence. Right? Akhyati means he describes, and pruchati means he asks. There are confident, what you call it? There are talks which are very spiritually surcharged, and they are guhyam. They talk with each other about the secret of advancing in spiritual life. And guhyam also means a personal talk, right? By which the relationship, the love in that relationship, especially spiritual relationship, will blossom, right? Bhungte bhojayate chaiva. Bhungte means he accepts prasad, and bhojayate means he feeds prasad, right? So giving Krishna prasad to each other, right? That's why you see in the festivals what happens in India, actual the original Vedic culture, what would happen? Celebration means dadati pratigrihnati. You give gifts and accept gifts, right? Guhyam akhyati pruchati. People would come together, discuss Ramayana, discuss Mahabharata, discuss Bhagavad Gita. It would go on in villages. Practically every night people would come together and discuss these things. And that's how the loving bonding would form. Bhungte bhojayate. People would invite each other to their homes, and they would serve them, nice, delicious items which are offered to Lord, right? Very nice, delicious Krishna Prasad. So that's how the spiritual relationship will develop. And we need a Sangha, an atmosphere wherein we can do this, right? And that's why this counselor system or the groups, under one counselor or one mentor, they serve this purpose wherein we develop a very strong and close relationship with the devotees of Lord. And that will help us to give our attention and attachment more and more on the path of Krishna consciousness, right? So we see some challenges now because of which this counselor system or mentor system started. As the number of devotees in congregation increases, it becomes difficult to give personal time and attention to everyone. And it also becomes difficult to check individual's growth and his progress, right? That is missing it. His growth and his progress in spiritual life. So that's why there are modules, it's divided into groups. by which it becomes easy. Counselor system or mentor system was started to train devotees and to bring them closer in warm relationships. Everyone, this is the line, you know, which we have for counselor system. Everyone teaches one while being taught by one. No? Everyone teaches one while being taught by one. So one is teaching another and he is teaching some others, right? So everyone is guided and everyone guides someone, right? So that is how it works. So that is the need of this system, wherein we get that bonding and personal touch and personal guidance by which we can advance very nicely on our path of spiritual progress. Yes, now we'll go ahead. Someone else can read. Purpose of counselor system. Yes.
Purpose, I'll read.
Yes.
Purpose of counselor system: to educate and train devotees to live according to the Krishna conscious principles, to provide systematic training to devotees in matters of philosophy, sadhana and Vaishnava behavior, etiquette, lifestyle, attitudes.
Yeah. So that is a purpose. You know? What happens by this counselor system? The devotees are educated and trained to live according to Krishna conscious principles, because to live with Krishna conscious principles is very difficult in today's day and age. And we need education and proper guidance by which we don't make mistakes. Or generally, the tendency is to go to extremes. Extreme means one becomes too fanatic, you know, and he'll go and hit everyone, you know, with his words and with his behavior, and create a very bad image and create many problems when you go to that extreme of being fanatic. Another extreme is being, you know, so loose that you keep compromising, you know, then there is no end of compromising and you never practice Krishna consciousness seriously. So that is what can happen. So we need a proper balanced guidance. Second thing is, you know, systematic training. We have nice, you know, topics, you know, which we discussed about philosophy of Krishna consciousness, our personal sadhana, our own connection with Krishna, how to behave as a proper Vaishnava, how to represent the Guru Parampara properly, what are the Vaishnava etiquettes, what are the lifestyles, what should be our attitude while dealing with everyone, you know, the devotees, the outside people, relatives, family members, everything. Next, read ahead. Quick, read ahead.
To provide a formal framework within which personal care and attention can be extended to all devotees so as to make them feel loved and wanted and part of a wonderful spiritual family.
It's a framework wherein there are groups and they are taken care, every individual is taken care with attention so that he feels loved, wanted and part of a very nice spiritual family. Because as I said, you know, in previously Rupa Goswami quotes, Sadvidham Priti Lakshanam. If that Priti Lakshanam gets developed, then a person feels satisfied in heart and he feels valued, and that everyone wants in every part of our life. And if that we get in a spiritual atmosphere, we will get more and more attached to the process of Krishna consciousness very nicely. Yes, read ahead.
To foster warm personal relationships and a spirit of love and trust amongst devotees based on Krishna consciousness principle.
Yes. Next.
As a forum through which allocation of service, organization of major events, communication of important decisions, etc. can be facilitated.
So whenever there are festivals, there are programs, there are services, there are organization of events, so person will feel connected to someone. You know, the person's connection through a big community of devotees, like in Pune we have around 5,000 devotees. So, you know, if you come to temple, you should find connection, right? Or, you know, wherever you are, you know, you should find connection to that community. And if you just go there and you don't know anyone, you know, although you like that atmosphere, you feel very nice, kirtan is going on, prasadam distribution is going on, some class is going on, deities are there, darshan. But if you don't have a connection, you will feel lost even in that atmosphere. But once when you get that connection, you know, then you identify with that because you have some part to play there, right? Unless you share that part, you don't feel like, you know, connected, you know, to the whole system, to the whole family. So that gets facilitated very nicely, right? And important decisions which are to be taken in our own life and in the part of community, you know? So sometimes the counselors are asked what to be done by this, then, you know, your opinions and your views can be conveyed. You get a channel to convey, you know, your concerns or your suggestions, everything, right, which you want to implement. So that is the purpose, you know, of counselor system. All those things which we discussed: training, education, and all those things, behavior, etiquette, lifestyle, attitudes, and connection to the whole community of devotees, and feeling of being valued and being loved. That is very important. And to get warm personal relationships. How does it work? How does this counselor system work? Please read.
Certain senior devotees from the congregation and Brahmachari ashram are nominated to be counselors. The counselors meet with their respective counselees once every fortnight. In the case of married devotee families, the meetings usually take place turn by turn at the homes of devotees in the group. Besides the meetings, the counselors maintain personal touch with their counselees to ensure their welfare.
Yeah. So, there are certain devotees, both brahmacharis like me, who stay in the temple and serve full time, and most of them are the congregation devotees, who are having their family, wife, children, and they're staying in the nearby, you know, the temple. So, some of them are counselors. Like I stay in Pune. So, Pune, we have around 50 brahmacharis as brahmachari counselors and around 60 to 80 congregation counselors who are taking care of the families who are practicing spiritual life, right? So, they meet. They conduct the meetings with their group of counselees every fortnight, every 15 days, every month. And besides that, they have personal touch with the counselors, with the counselees, right? To ensure that their practice of spiritual life is going on very nicely. Yes. Read ahead.
New devotees are encouraged either through announcements at the Sunday feast program or in personal discussions to participate in the counselor system. Thus, an effort is made to bring as many devotees as possible under the umbrella of the counselor system.
Yes. So, devotees are encouraged that you get connected through this, by which you can get connected to the community, you know. Yes. Read ahead.
Unmarried boys, students and working are looked after by brahmachari counselors who are preaching to them. When these boys express desire to enter grihastha ashram, they are handed over to suitable grihastha counselors, husband-wife couple. Then their relation with the brahmacharya is more as a spiritual inspiration.
Their relationship with brahmachari, not brahmacharya.
Then their relation with brahmachari is more as a spiritual inspiration then detailed counseling about family related subjects. Unmarried girls are looked
after. Most of you are unmarried, you know, those who are attending this program. So those who are unmarried, they are taken care by brahmacharis. Like I am taking classes and talking with some of you personally. So they are taken care by brahmachari counselors. And when there is a proper age, when you all will get married and all, so then you also need a family, you know, guidance about a proper grihastha ashram in Krishna consciousness. Then there is a grihastha counselor which will help you to get connected to the community very nicely. So then the relationship with brahmachari will remain as a spiritual inspiration. Yes, the relationship will not get lost, but, you know, that will be not in so much of details of family life and all those things. Yes. Read ahead. Unmarried girls.
Unmarried girls are looked after by congregation Mataji counselors. Those who are already married are also handed over to Grihastha counselor couple for Grihastha ashram related guidance. In many cases, wherein a devotee is strongly connected to
leave it. So those who are ladies here or Matajis are there, the Brahmacharis don't guide Matajis directly. That is not a proper etiquette. But they will be connected to some ladies, senior Matajis who are counselors. They will be taken care. They will guide you on your spiritual path. And those who are already married, they will also be taken care by Grihastha counselors. Some of you are already married and you should be connecting to some Grihastha counselor to get proper guidance in your life. And sometimes, when there is strong relationship with a Brahmachari, then both Brahmachari congregation, they together also guide in some cases. But even if you get connected to a Grihastha counselor, that doesn't mean the connection with the Brahmachari counselor is lost. Like I am conducting classes, all of you are attending. Like this can go on if you are interested to take part, and you can also connect to a family, right? Wherein you can get proper guidance. Okay, so these are the nomination of counselor. How is counselor chosen and all those things? That is not that you can understand in detail later. Yeah, so counselor is properly practicing Krishna consciousness. He has spent sufficient amount of time in Krishna consciousness. He must be practicing for 10, 15 years. He should be a good listener, mature, sober, stable individual. He should have good sadhana, etiquette, behavior, commitment to the mission and all those things, right? Yes, so what a counselor does, that is here, right? A counselor is a friend, philosopher and guide in Krishna consciousness. So he plays this part of three things. He is a friend, philosopher and guide. He's like a spiritual elder brother or sister and takes personal care of devotees in the group. He should inspire and encourage their counselees in Krishna consciousness, monitor their progress. So he does these five things basically. Five S. What are they? Swasthya, sadhana, swadhyaya, sadachar and seva. Is the person who is under his care, is maintaining good health, then only he can practice spiritual life properly. Then his own sadhana, is he chanting properly? Is he having good connection with the spiritual vibration? Then swadhyaya, his study of the scriptures, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam. Is he hearing the classes from Srila Prabhupada or his spiritual master? How is his behavior? That is sadachar, seva. Is he contributing some seva for the mission in some way or the other? That is also a very important factor, right? When it comes to the responsibility of the counselor towards the counselee. Yes, they are expected to provide Krishna conscious training to their counselees. They are required to counsel their counselees wherever, not only in spiritual matters, but sometimes also on personal or domestic, wherever necessary, whenever is it required. In other words, they have to look into the overall welfare of the devotee counselee. Yes, they conduct fortnightly meetings. The counselor takes regular yatras, that is the spiritual outings with the devotees in his group. Like we go many times, so many dhams we have gone, practically, 10 to 15 yatras we have taken for the devotees, many places, sometimes for two days, three days, sometimes for a week, once in a year, once in a semester, like that. So it is a very nice experience of going to a holy place like Ahobilam or Tirupati, or we go to Pandharpur, we go to Dwarka, we go to Vrindavan, Jagannath Puri, Shidham Mayapur, we go to Srirangam, we go to Udupi, we go to Hampi. So many places are there. So many more places. I'm missing some names, but we go for yatras. And also there are yatras of the spiritual masters that also the counselor recommends the counselee for going. And this is very important. The counselor recommends the counselee for initiation. Those who are interested to go ahead and become serious spiritual practitioners, the counselor recommends their their you know request for getting initiation from a Diksha Guru, from a spiritual master. As leaders, they are expected to set a good standard of sadhana, service and behavior. So that is also very important. So what training a counselee is given by the counselor? How to be an ideal student or working professional, grihastha, by keeping Krishna in the center. So when I'm talking both as a what a brahmachari counselor gives and what a grihastha couple, you know, as a counselor imparts the training, you know, at different phases of life of a person. How to maintain proper spiritual standards and devotional culture at home, like kitchen, altar, how to worship Lord at home, how to create that spiritual atmosphere at home, how to maintain cleanliness at home, proper Vaishnava standards of behavior. So many such things, cultural things and spiritual things are, you know, given guidance for in this counselor system. How to deal properly with wife, husband, parents, children, relatives, colleagues, as per the description in the scriptures, very properly, sensitively, in a mature way. How to balance economic and social responsibilities along with our spiritual vows and practices, because that is very important, because when living in a family, you have to be very careful in these financial and social responsibilities. How women should be dealt, how women should deal with men, particularly brahmacharis and sannyasis, how men should deal with women, how to have proper attitude towards other ashramas. If I am in brahmachari ashram, how shall I respect others in grihastha ashram and vice versa, right? The counselor also resolves conflicts and disagreements within a family, if there are, between a devotee and his relatives or between two devotees, and thus train them to deal with each other a very proper, sensitive way of spiritual practice, right? Of Krishna conscious way. A manual of Vaishnava etiquette and lifestyle is made, and that also is discussed in the meetings. Like that, that's how also it is. The training is imparted for the counselees. And what is the general format of these meetings when a counselor and counselee meet? So they sing very beautiful Vaishnava bhajans, as we sang, you know, in our mantra meditation workshop. There are hundreds of very beautiful songs which are sung. There is some reading from the books of Srila Prabhupada. There are some philosophical discussions, right, on some relevant topics which we can apply in our life. There is sharing of realizations when the such meetings happen. And there are discussions on services for the, you know, spreading of Krishna consciousness, or services for deities in the temple, services for the community, services for celebrating very beautiful festivals like Janmashtami, Radhashtami, Balaram Jayanti, Gaur Purnima, Diwali, and so many other festivals which are celebrated. And discussions about doing very nice sadhana, personal spiritual practices, nice sadachar, like that is Vaishnava behavior, developing right culture in the, you know, our association, in our family. Celebrations of important festivals, that is also done sometimes in the meetings. And devotees are asked if they want to discuss any problems which are not personal, and that can be discussed in the meetings. And personal problems are discussed in private with the counselor, right? And if there are some question answers or some doubts, this is a general format in which some counselor meetings are conducted once in 15 days or once in 20 days, either physically or online, depending on our, you know, physical situation where we are situated. And then there are kirtan, chanting of holy names with musical instruments, and then there is prasadam for everyone. That is how a general, typical counselor meeting happens, you know, once in 15 days. And all the devotees meet in a counselor group. There are generally 10, 15, 20, 30, not more than that, wherein you can have personal relationship with everyone. If it becomes too big, it becomes too difficult, right? So it's a small family kind of group wherein you have a very personal relationship with everyone, and you can share your sorrows and your joys with everyone. Okay, whatever we have discussed till now, any questions anyone has about this system? Yes, anyone has any questions? We are missing Prasadam here. Yes. Okay, I live in Hinjewadi. So I am asking, do you have any question?
Yeah, one question regarding that. I live in Pune only, but not nearby to any temple. So
how I will discuss that. Then? I will discuss that ahead. About the principles, what we discuss. Personal details we'll discuss. I have one more point ahead, and then after that we can discuss personal details. Any okay. Question about the principles which we discussed about this counseling system which we follow?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji.
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. हाँ प्रभुजी मैं यही पूछना चाह रहा था कि जैसे आईडीसी कोर्स के लिए अगर अगर एप्लीकेबल है अगर आईडीसी कोर्स करते तो कैसे किसी काउंसलर के अंतर्गत कैसे जाएंगे हम ये कैसे पता करना पड़ता है
ओके ओके एनी अदर आई विल आंसर दैट आगे उसको उत्तर मिल जाएगा आपको और कोई प्रश्न है Okay, no question.
हरे कृष्ण प्रभुजी
यस हरे कृष्ण
मला विचारायचं होतं की एटिकेट्स काय फॉलो करायचे जनरली जेव्हा टेम्पलला वगैरे जातोय
या दॅट वी विल डिस्कस लेटर दॅट इज अ पर्टिक्युलर क्वेश्चन अबाउट एटिकेट्स दॅट कॅन बी डिस्कस्ड इन द यू नो फर्दर क्लासेस वी विल हॅव क्लासेस ऑन एटिकेट्स ऑल्सो आय एम आस्किंग एनी क्वेश्चन्स अबाउट द काउन्सलर सिस्टम Okay, I think there is no question. So now there are some questions that I live here, I stay here and I want to do IDC course and so many things. So the action plan is, if you are interested, you know, we will send a Google link if you want to get connected to the counselor system and follow Krishna consciousness seriously. Some of you are already practicing very nicely. Many here are chanting 8 rounds. Some are chanting 16 rounds. Some are chanting 4 rounds. Just type in the chat box how many rounds you are chanting. Okay, Chaitanya is chanting 8 rounds. Others quickly. Okay, Krishna is chanting 4 rounds. Very good. Anish is chanting 9. Chaitanya Prabhu is chanting 5. Sagar Prabhu is chanting 6. Very good. Many others are chanting 16 rounds also. Like we have Karan Prabhu. Ashutosh Prabhu, how many are chanting? Okay. Deepika Mataji chanting 1 round, Sagar Prabhu chanting 16, Rajkumar Prabhu chanting 16, Karan Prabhu chanting 16, Ashutosh Prabhu chanting 4, very good. Aditya Prabhu, Aditya Thakur, you are from which place? Aditya Prabhu?
From Kolhapur, but abhi main Pune mein job kar raha
hoon.
Kolhapur se hoon Prabhu ji.
Pune mein job kar rahe hain? पॉइंट इज इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गेट इन टू दिस काउंसलिंग सिस्टम वी विल सेंड अ गूगल लिंक वेर इन यू कैन fill it and send it and if you want you know I can serve as a brahmachari counselor for those who of you want and when the right time comes I can connect you to a proper grihastha couple wherein you get guidance for all further things of your krishna consciousness like your family life and how to practice krishna consciousness in grihastha ashram for your initiation ahead if you want to you know be a serious practitioner of krishna consciousness and get diksha So all those things can be done ahead in future. But right now, for doing, like he's asking about IDC course, you should be connected to someone so that it can be covered and you can go ahead for initiation. And for initiation also, if you want to, you know, you need a recommendation from someone whom you are connected, whom you are accountable to. You know, the recommendation is not just done like that. Someone who knows you, whom you are connected to, you are accountable to, and you are reporting to, such person can recommend you. Right for initiation to go ahead you cannot directly approach a guru a spiritual master you have to go through the channel of you know some other person who is senior so that way it is important So those of you want, you can go through, right? This Google form, and then you can fill it. And if you want, or if you are already having some counselor, you're already connected to someone. Just someone connected to someone is not counselor. A counselor is a person who is nominated, right? And who is a representative of that temple, of that community. Like for me personally, I stay in Pune NVCC, and I also visit Kolhapur every month. I couldn't visit last 6 months because of this situation of lockdown. But otherwise, I visit every month for 3-4 days and conduct the programs for youth there. So that way, those who are in Kolhapur and are staying in Kolhapur only, I can connect to some, I know many devotees there, Grihasthas also. And we can connect, Radha Gopinath Prabhu comes there under his guidance. I am trying to serve in Kolhapur temple also as a youth preaching service. So we had a long meetings with His Grace Radha Gopinath Prabhu, and we had a plan of connecting devotees properly in the counseling system to Grihasthas. And because of this, some lockdown, many things collapsed and it stopped practically. But as the time goes ahead, we'll try for all these things. So wo hoga dheere dheere aage jaake. But for that, you should at least be connected either to a brahmachari counselor or to a nominated grihastha counselor. Others can be your connection, your relationship is all fine. He may be a senior devotee, very good, but he cannot recommend you for further things like initiation, yatras and all those things. For that, you need a proper official connection with a person who is nominated by the community, nominated by the temple, who is a proper counselor. So that way, okay, I am only 70 year old, so no problem. So what is the problem? If you are 70 year old, you're already practicing Krishna consciousness nicely. He's asking, I'm only 70 year old. So age doesn't matter. 17 years means you are quite mature. You're practicing Krishna consciousness only. That means you're chanting every day Hare Krishna. You are much more, having much more wisdom than a person who has spent 70 years, but who is not practicing Krishna consciousness. What is your question with your 17 year old age? No question? Yes? Can I join? Oh yeah, everyone can join. There is no age bar. You don't have to be an adult or something like that. 18 plus. We are not doing anything. We are just, having a, guidance on spiritual path. That's it. It's all a voluntary thing. And there is no compulsion or there is no... If you want to seriously practice Krishna consciousness, you can get connected to, right? So I was telling, I stay in Pune and visit Kolhapur every month. And even if you are at other place, I am available on mail, and some are already connected through mail, phone. Last 6 months, there is no physical meeting. Yeah, but also we have some basic expectations from those who get connected. You can't just tell I am connected to this person, and don't do anything. So the relationship is reciprocal. If you reciprocate, then that relationship, it cannot be one way. Yeah. So those who want to get connected to me as Brahmachari counselor, I will be happy to serve. And appropriate time, I'll connect you to some Grihastha couple. But if you already have a Brahmachari counselor whom you are connected to, that is also fine. No problem. Right? And if you want someone else, you're not happy with this, person sitting in front of you, you can tell that also in that form. But you please get connected to someone whom you, want to follow. We cannot practice Krishna consciousness or any spiritual life on our own, That will create a lot of problems. We should have a proper guidance. Whomever you want, if he's a nominated, proper, bona fide person, you can get connected to, no issues, right? Yeah, those of you who already have a counselor, you don't have to fill the form. That person should be a counselor, right? He should be nominated. You can't say, I'm connected to this XYZ. He's some other devotee who himself is not practicing properly. He may be an initiated also, but he should be a counselor. You have to ask him. If you are considering that I am connected to him, you ask him, are you a counselor? Right? Can you recommend me for yatra? Can you recommend me for initiation? Right? All those things should be asked. If he should be a counselor, otherwise you can't call him, there are many people like that who are connected to someone, you know, and he is some person, you know, in the community, but that will not work. You know, you cannot put your letter in any box, you know, a red color box. That box should be bona fide, sanctioned. Those of you who want practice Krishna consciousness but don't want to be connected, yeah, connected to some other, I can arrange that also. But my only desire is you get properly connected to someone, right? That is very important. So I hope I conveyed. Your questions got answered. For IDC course, if you want to do, I'll just find out. We are getting the forms filled by all devotees. So I'll get the requirements for it. Those who all can attend, that I will just find out. I think it is 4 rounds and practicing, chanting 4 rounds every day minimum. Or I think 8 rounds. I'll just find out. But not surely 16 rounds. And all those who are chanting 16 rounds, they must attend. It is very important. And others also. I'll just find out what are the prerequisite for attending. Any other questions? Anyone has any other questions to be asked? Okay, no questions. How many of you want to get connected to counselor system? Please type yes in the chat box. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, thank you. Okay, so we will send the form to you. You just fill the form and then further things. You all can attend program even if you are not. Program attending is not a problem. But if you want to go ahead and practice Krishna consciousness, you get a guide for personal problem. What is that? Wrong message. Okay, so I will tell our devotees to send a link. You all can fill and you all can get connected and then practice your Krishna consciousness. Yes, any question? Okay, if you don't have any questions, then I think we can stop here. It's 8:15. If you have any questions, you can ask. If you want to ask some personal questions also, you can ask later. You can call and ask, or if you have some doubts which you cannot express here, you can personally speak, not an issue. Thank you all very much for joining. You all are there on this game group, or some are in... IYS Kolhapur, I think some devotees are there here who are in that IYS group. Okay. No issues. Yeah. So we'll send it. Okay. Some are on the both, some are on only IYS. Just 1 second. Okay, thank you all very much. We'll meet tomorrow evening and you'll get the poster. We'll continue with the next topic of our Gita for All Made Easy game series. And we'll continue the discussions on that theme. You'll get a poster and we'll continue the discussion tomorrow evening. Hare Krishna. Thank you all very much. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.